When he couldn't stand it any longer, he asked me to help him. I couldn't at first. I loved him too much. But I did. And I held him.
Could I come and see you again, Grandma?
Get in here. Never mind. I'll look after you.
Righty-o! Line up, two lines. Arms length apart.
Oh, come on, Bay.
I like my body the way it is.
Does anyone else?
How the hell am I going to find out in here?
You've got nothing to lose.
Except a few inches.
I can still run rings around you.
Oh, yeah? Well, come up here and try.
Right,
go on.
Oh.
Hey, I'll never make it in the army. Okay, legs apart.
No need to tell Mason that.
You ever thought of getting off some of that lard?
Shape up your bludgers. Legs astride, arms out. Cross over, touching your toes. Left, right, left, right. Stop cheating, Doreen. Knees straight. Left.
How do you think I keep in shape?
Give you one guess. If you're bored, Doyle,
two,
I'll find something to keep you busy.
One, two, left, right, left, right.
Getting excited?
Uh-huh. Left. I wish I was going out today.
Oh, come on, Bee. You can do better than that.
Oh, tell my stomach that it keeps getting in the way.
Oh, Lynn. I've spoken to Mrs. Davidson and they've agreed to contact the police. Going to make further inquiries. Now, they're inquiries, mind you. Nothing more, understand?
All this for them to find out I didn't do it.
Oh, good. You're all set. I'm going to want to see you every day for the next week. I don't want you overdoing it, now that you're pregnant.
Who cares? I won't be keeping it anyway.
Wait outside a minute, would you, Lynn? Meg, our supplies of medicinal alcohol keep disappearing. These are the women who've had the opportunity. Any ideas?
Take your pick. They'll pinch anything not bolted down.
Certainly dealing with class, aren't we?
The cream of the crop. Do you want me to take this to the governor?
No, I'll do it.
Okay.
Little baby cat, I'm gonna look after you. We're gonna be friends.
What you got there, Lizzie?
She's mine.
Mangy looking thing, give you worms.
Get worse things from people.
Okay, stop. On your backs. Legs straighten on the ground. Lift up and touch your toes.
Oh, I haven't seen my toes for years.
That'll get your stomach off, Bee.
Well. But isn't our little baby snatcher?
That's enough, Doyle.
I'll be out soon. You wait.
Oh, yeah? You want to bet on it?
You don't know what you're talking about. And I won't warn you again.
I'm staying down here.
You'll be all right now?
Yeah. Oh, darling. Thanks, Mrs. Jackson.
Darling.
Oh, God, you're a bunch of softies.
Darling.
Is Greg still here?
Yes.
Would you take over?
Come at it.
No more.
Darling.
I'm sorry I've left this so late, but I was expecting Meg to relate me earlier.
Well, she wanted to check on Lim Warner.
Yes, well, I suppose we should be grateful she's acting like her old self.
Hmm?
Favouring some of the prisoners.
Well, I think Meg knows what she's doing, don't you? And do you want to talk in the office?
No, it's okay. Would you be able to see my mother this evening?
Yes, how was she last night?
Oh, just about the same. But she's still complaining of pains in her legs.
To be expected. Not getting about as much as she could.
Your friends are outside playing trim the fat. But then I don't reckon you need trimming.
What you think doesn't interest me.
Well, I like fighters. Bet you're a real mover in bed.
Whatever turns you on.
You do, sweetie.
Get out of my way.
Make me. You're sick.
Of course, I can't force her to do anything.
No.
I mean, I've tried.
Ah! Oh, what's going on?
Oh, she pushed me. God, I think I'll break my arm.
She's lying.
She pushed me, I tell you.
You forget any privileges for the next 24 hours. And any more trouble, and you'll be in front of the governor.
That feels good.
Oh, I wish you weren't getting out today, Marilyn.
That's a dumb thing to say.
Oh, it means we'll have to break in a new waxer.
Oh. I'll miss you too, Doreen. Mm. Oh, it's going to feel funny being a housewife. Yeah, well, it won't be that until after you're married, and that better not be too far off.
Oh, what's wrong with living with a bloke? I did.
Yeah, look where it got you.
I'm not very good at housework, and my cooking's lousy. What if any get sick of me?
Oh, crikey, Moses, cooking's easy. Look at all the food they have in the supermarket. You just put it in the oven, heat it up, Bob's your uncle.
I should have done a course in here.
Look, you'll learn from your mistakes. I did. Besides, Eddie loves you. He'll give you time.
Yeah, so did the cops.
Oh.
Oh. It's going to come up in a nasty bruise. Keep it clean, it should heal, all right?
Oh, I've had worse than this, Doc. What's a pommy doc like you doing in a women's prison, anyhow? Like the fringe benefits, do you?
Antiseptic, please, sister.
Hey, you make cell calls, darling? You don't talk much, do you? What, are you saving your bedside manner for your staff, are you?
Pretty tough, aren't you, Franky?
That's right.
Ah! Oh, I'm sorry.
And I'm gonna bring you some of my dinner. So don't you try running away. Oh, you dear little thing.
Morning.
Someone should tell him he needs glasses.
Ah, you were a thirsty little cat. Oh.
It tastes all in his mouth.
Well, the men are out there now, so I'll take it to them.
Come in. Oh, Dr. Miller, I thought you'd left for your private practice.
I have one more patient.
Anything serious?
Oh, nothing a little mouthwash wouldn't fix.
You'll be pleased to know we're finally getting that drainage system repaired by the male prisoners next door.
Prisoners?
Oh, they do a good enough job, and it's well within our budget.
Thank you.
Did you want to see me about something?
Yes, we're missing a number of things from surgery.
Drugs?
Not yet, but it could come to that.
Have you any idea who's responsible?
Security's pretty tight.
Well, we better do a spot search of the rooms, although I don't hold out much hope. The places those women hide things, you'd be amazed.
No, I wouldn't.
Bloody will leave me alone, I'm sick and tired of you, I'm vexed! Yes, I'm bloody vexed!
Put that down. You're behaving like an animal.
Yeah, well, tell him to leave me alone.
I haven't touched you yet.
I've just about had enough of you, Doyle. Now, there's a visitor out there for you, and I've a damn good mind not to let you see him.
You can't do that.
Well, you just keep it in mind. Come on. All right, sis.
Hey, Gazza. My brother.
You still want to live on a farm, don't you, Franky?
Oh, sure.
I've been talking to the welfare officer at the home, see? And he reckons if you behave yourself, you could be out in 3 years.
Oh, bull. Just tell you those things to keep you in line.
He knows what he's talking about.
Yeah, I know.
But you've got to stay out of trouble.
I'm the best they've got in here, Gazza.
Look, I'm trying to be serious. Will you listen?
Yeah, well, don't get your nappy in a knot. Okay, I'm listening.
Look, 3 years will give me time to get us a farm. At least put a deposit on one. Yeah. Did you copy the plans for our house? You can keep it if you like.
Yeah, sure.
But you've got to promise me you won't get into any trouble.
No sweat. Well, we're Doyles, aren't we? Doyle can do anything they put their minds to, easy. I won't let you down, Gazza. Promise you.
You got enough of my prints to make up a book.
It's hardly something to be proud of.
Oh, I bet you'd find it interesting reading, though, Miss Bennett.
You've got a smutty mind, Gladys.
Well, you can call me Marilyn. Some of my worst enemies do. Time to say goodbye, Franky.
When I get out of here, I'll look you up. Always wanted a massage.
By the time you get out, you'll be too old to care.
Wouldn't bet on it.
Anyway, who says when I get out, I'll be going back to my old job?
People like you always go back to the mud.
You should know.
On your way, Doyle.
Hi, Marilyn. We thought we'd missed you.
Oh, I wouldn't leave without saying goodbye. What's wrong with you?
Oh, she's stiffening up from the exercises. Talk about out of shape.
I am not. I just pulled a muscle.
Sign the disbursement book.
I'll come visit you.
You're no such thing. I never want to see you near this place again.
Oh, B.
Look, you've got your own life to lead now. And the only time I want to hear from you is when you tell me that you and Eddie are doing the right thing and getting married. Clothing card.
B, marriage doesn't solve everything.
Yeah, well, it's a good start. Well, don't take all day, Mason.
Hey, don't take any brass knuckles. Well,
take care.
You too, Bea.
Well, what do you think?
It's very cozy.
Well, it's not much to look at, but it's got a good feel about it, don't you reckon? The only thing wrong with it is we have to share the bathroom. But only with Joe and another old bloke. And they don't use it very often. Almost forgot. I'm sorry it's not,
Oh, Eddie. It's lovely.
What do you mean, sneaking in on people?
It's my room, too.
Well, what are you pinched now?
Nothing.
You just grow that, did you?
She's staying with me.
Like bloody hell she is, stupid moth-eaten thing.
She only needs a bit of looking after.
Yeah, well, then do it outside.
Well, they'll get rid of her if they find her.
And I'll wring its flaming neck if it's here when I get back.
God, I'm sick of this. Come on, Doreen, you're as slow as a wet week.
Oh, what do you expect? I'm on my own.
Get yourself out of shape. Oh, geez, Lizzie, gotta move on. We're short-handed as it is.
Hey, Doreen, have a look.
Oh, what a cutie.
Hey, be gentle. Don't hurt her.
Oh, I'm only patting it.
What is that thing doing in here?
She was cold.
Put it back where it belongs, Lizzie.
It's not safe.
Well, cats can look after themselves. Besides, they'll stink the place out.
Oh, B.
Belled up, Doreen. Out.
But what about those men? They might strike trouble or something.
Men! They're gone now.
Oh, why didn't you tell us before?
I'll be back tomorrow.
You beautiful. I'll come here for teasing. Jeez, look at this bloody press thing. I'm going to go on strike. Damn water everywhere.
I can't stand.
Nothing in this place works.
No.
Oh, what's
that?
You? No.
Oh, don't tell me. Will you check
her out? What's that? Yeah. Mother's little helper.
Yeah. Frankie Doyle's been to see me, asking what her chances of parole are. Claims she's turned over a new leaf.
I wouldn't trust her as far as I could throw her.
Meg?
Well, normally I'd go along with Vera, but having seen her with her brother, it's certainly a different Franky.
Do you think it's enough incentive for her to keep out of trouble?
Hard to say, with that temper of hers.
She won't change. I've seen women like her before. You could be right, but at this stage we should give her the benefit of the doubt.
Well, I think it'd be a mistake to give her special treatment.
I'm not suggesting we do. We carry on as usual. Oh, by the way, I'd appreciate it if you could both stay back for a spot search tonight.
Of course.
I'm afraid I can't, Mrs. Davidson. Well, my mother hasn't been at all well, and I really ought to get home.
Oh, nothing too serious, I hope.
Well, she seems to be getting worse.
Well, I don't see why we can't have the search first thing in the morning, then.
That'll be a great help. Thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
Hello, Mum.
You're late.
I shop Thursdays, you know that. God, it's so dark in here.
I couldn't get off the sofa all day. My legs were giving me trouble.
Well, they will if you sit there all day.
And just how am I supposed to get about? Nobody knows the pain.
Dr. Miller's coming over later. He'll give you something.
Oh, nothing helps. But you don't care.
Was lunch okay?
I managed to eat it.
Then let me get in a part-time nurse.
I'm not having any stranger in this house, Vera. It's a daughter's duty to look after a mother. Now think of all those years bringing you up by myself, giving you the best education I could, trouble I had. But you never heard me complain. No one wants you when you're old and sick, not even your own daughter.
I just thought a nurse would make things easier for you.
Yes, yeah, so you can wipe your hands of me. Next thing is you'll be wanting to put me in a home.
I won't.
Stuck in here all day. No one to talk to. I see you for a few hours and all you do is pick on me. Think I enjoy the pain? Think I like being sick?
Bounce, 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 bounce. Boing, bounce, bounce, bounce. Boing, boing. Jump, 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 jump. Live it. Today, live more of your life.
Here. Kitty, 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 kitty. Kitty, 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 kitty.
I got a surprise for you.
Come on. Come and get your dinner. Here. Come on. Where are you? Kitty, 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 kitty. Get your...
Anymore.
She couldn't have strife over Frankie. Old sow, poor stick away her privileges.
I don't know why Frankie doesn't leave that girl alone.
Yeah, from what I heard, Karen started it.
She wouldn't do that.
Oh, boy, have you missed out on a lot since you've been in hospital. That little lady is turning out to be pretty tough.
Heaven help us, one Frankie's quite enough.
Here.
Pig! You killed my cat! I'll kill you, I swear!
will!
You're off, you flaming rocker!
Oh, you hated her because she was my friend!
Oh, go on, the main she's the old thing's better off dead, and so would you be.
Lizzie, shall I only hurt you?
You pig! Big fat pig! You're queer! You ought to be shot! Pig! 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 Pig!
Big, 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 big.
Your blood pressure is still too high, Mrs. Bennett. You must be careful not to get excited. I'll prescribe you some more tablets, but promise me that you'll take them.
Yes, Doctor. Oh, it's hard not to worry, though. I hate being such a burden to Vera. She's got her own life to lead. She can't always be running after me.
Did Vera mention bringing in a nurse?
We did discuss it. And Vera feels she'd be happier looking after me herself.
All right, Mrs. Bennett. Now, you take care. I'll be able to see you again soon.
Thank you, Doctor.
I'll show you out, Greg.
It's a pleasure. Just make sure that she takes those tablets, because there's no point otherwise. I do realize. Yes, of course. See you tomorrow. Good night.
Bye. It's nice to see you on your feet again.
He's quite a good doctor. Why can't you get yourself a man like that?
Oh, look, don't start that again.
You're starting to look like a shriveled up old prune. No man would look twice at you.
Well, whose fault's that? I've been looking after you for 12 years. When have I had a chance to even meet a man?
No, that's right. Blame me. Well, just look at where you work. A prison. Why can't you get yourself a decent job? You're getting old and hard before your years, Vera.
Oh, look, lay off, Mum. Just lay off.
You're just like a little kid, you know that?
Just one more minute. I've been promising myself this for 6 months. The worst bit about being inside is the same old thing every night. Lights out at 10. Never a minute before or a minute after. Always 10 on the dot.
Well, you can always watch it from here, you know. I promised to keep you up till 11.
You better.
Move along, girls. Nothing. Right, spot check, girls.
Bloody invasion of privacy.
Who the bloody hell's keeping them?
They're looking for the one who killed my cat, and I'm gonna tell them.
Oh, belt up, you old idiot.
I should have killed you last night when I had a chance.
You were stinking drunk and you wouldn't have the guts.
Spot check. On your feet, Lizzie.
That's private.
All right, Franky. Miss Bennett.
Mrs. Davidson.
They've been planted.
Lizzie the Bowerbird. I might have known. Why on earth would you want this?
It was for me cat. You got plenty.
And the alcohol?
I had to have something to make me sleep. I'm locked up with a killer. It's her you ought to punish. She killed my cat.
She probably smothered it to death.
See, he gave it a drink out of this. What was in it?
Water.
Where'd you get it?
Out of a bucket. It was rainwater.
So if I'm any judge, it's got some sort of weed killer in it. If your cat was sick or just a kitten.
You can go, Franky. You
didn't let the others out. And she trusted me.
I think you've learned your lesson, Lizzie. So we won't take this matter any further.
Hey, Franky.
don't tell me you got out the right side of bed for a change.
You know, you and that bird brain Lizzie make a good pair. Always chirping out of tune.
Oh, she's funny this morning.
You want to touch me, sweetie? We can go to your room.
I wouldn't touch you if my life depended on it. What's the matter, having trouble with your fat feet?
Whoever do that to me?
You can dish it up, but you can't take it, can
That's
you?
That's enough. I don't tolerate troublemakers in here, understand?
Mum?
Yes?
I think it would be a good idea if Franky Doyle worked in the garden, just for a while.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
It might be best to keep her away from the others.
Franky or Karen?
I just can't figure out why Frankie's backing down.
Yeah, Lizzie would be dead by now. Not to mention Karen.
She's got to be up to something. Frankie doesn't run.
Hello, Lizzie.
G'day.
Oh, don't worry, Lizzie. We'll find you another cat.
It won't be the same.
It wasn't really your fault. People shouldn't leave stuff like that lying around.
It's a punishment. I knew God would get his own back. It took him 10 years, but I knew he wouldn't forget.
Being in here is punishment enough. Anyway, you only meant to scare him.
All
God would know that.
Complaining about my cooking, and what would Shearers know about food anyway?
Nothing.
Yeah. So I showed him.
Yeah.
I gave him something to really complain about.
4 out of 6 is pretty good.
Shearers aren't so tough.
No.
But I only meant to scare him. I didn't mean to bump him off.
Yeah, well, poison's real tricky stuff. Yeah. You weren't to know.
Neither did my little cat.
Could have been sick anyway.
You think so?
Didn't look well to me.
She knew I loved her.
Of course she did.
But what about Franky? I blamed her. She'll kill me.
He'll look after you.
God, I need a drink.
Can I come in? You want to have a go at me too, do you? I think you know me better than that. I was wondering if you'd like to work in the garden. Now, I know it's not really your cup of tea, but it might give time for things to settle down a bit.
I could look after myself.
Oh, I've no doubt about that. Frankly, it isn't difficult to see you're making an effort to control your temper.
And what would you know?
Oh, nothing much, I suppose. I was just trying to help.
Well, hang on a sec. What do you mean you can see I'm trying to control my temper?
Well, aren't you?
Didn't think anyone would notice.
You don't often run away from trouble.
Yeah, well, I've got this kid brother, you see. I've been looking after him since he was about 8, and he sort of still needs me. Thought I'd better get out. He's got this dumb idea about building a place like this.
Oh, looks lovely.
Yeah, he's sort of the bright spark of the family.
It's not going to be easy, Franky. Once the others find out you won't fight back and they suspect something already, could get rough on you. You've got rather a lot to live down.
I'll give it a go then.
Oh, come on, Doreen.
No way. The last time I was set to go, you went and got yourself boozed. Well, if you're going to break out this time, you're on your own. But I've got a beaut idea how you can do it.
Yeah?
I read it in a comic. The trick is you get yourself moved to some place easier to break out of.
Where?
A mental home.
What do you mean?
Oh, no, you just pretend you're nutty. Like you got, anemia.
What?
You know, anemia. You can't remember anything, your name or nothing.
How'd you get it?
From a bump on the head or a bad shock. And you've had a bad shock because your cat died, right?
How am I supposed to look?
Like you haven't got a brain. Work on it.
What's
hoping you've been today.
Yeah, I got in a bit late, I'm afraid.
Oh, heavy night, huh?
You could say that.
Yeah. How is she?
Couldn't be better. She's one in a million, B, you know that. It's real good having someone to come home to.
Oh, look, why, remember, give her these. There are some of the recipes. She might like to try them.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Someone to cook for me as well, eh?
Yeah.
She ought to see the doctor.
What's the matter, Lizzie?
I don't know. It's the shock of her cat. She can't remember anything, doesn't know where she is. I'm real worried, Mrs. Jackson.
Is this true, Lizzie?
Yes, yes. The doctor, is the doctor here? Where am I? Who are you?
Needs a bit more work, Lizzie.
You must be feeling very proud of yourself. I thought maybe we could have a chat.
We don't have anything to say to each other.
I think we do.
I'm listening.
The idea was that you might want to speak to me.
I got nothing to say to you.
What's happening to you, Karen? You've been in here a couple of months and you're behaving like an animal. Have you looked at yourself lately? You're worse than that Doyle character. She can't help what she is, but you're an intelligent woman and you're sinking to her level. Why?
Go to hell.
I refuse to stand here and watch you destroy yourself. Believe it or not, I still have some feelings for you and I want to help.
Then you're a fool.
I want to help you, damn it!
Can't you get it through that thick, idealistic skull of yours? I don't need your help. I don't want it. So bloody well butt out of my life!
Karen!
You know nothing. Nothing. So just leave me alone. Get back to your medical books and stop trying to be a quack psychologist. I'll report you for that.
That wasn't a very smart thing to do, even if she did deserve it.
I'm aware of that, Vera.
If she reports this, you could be thrown out.
She won't. Not Karen.
You seem to know her pretty well.
It's a personal matter, Vera.
No luck?
I lost my temper. What is it with this place, Meg? Seems to turn everybody into Jekyll and Hyde.
I know. Look, how about coming over for dinner tonight?
Oh, a touch of sanity.
I don't know about that, but at least we could talk.
Thanks, Meg.
7:30?
Fine.
I wasn't aware that Greg knew Karen Travis.
Did he say that?
It was pretty obvious.
Excuse me, Vera.
Come on, Lizzie, you share with her. How do we go about it?
Bash her up!
Oh, no, it's got to be something that's not going to get us into strife. Hey, Karen, you and Franky look like you're heading in the direction of a head-on crash. We figure she's up to something. Want to help us stir her up a bit, find out what's really going on?
Fight your own battles. I'll settle with her myself.
Oh. Come on, Lizzie, think. There must be something. Listen, has she got anything she really values and would hate to see anything happen to? Well, think. There must be.
Yeah,
I remember.
Oh, watch what you're doing.
What?
You did that deliberately.
Oh, it's only a plant.
Yeah, well, it shows what you know.
Lynn, you work over there.
Why does she have to work here anyway?
Thanks, Dunno. Mates call me Doug the Mug. Your mum doesn't, but she calls me Doug the Thug. What's your mum call you?
Lynette, but everyone here calls me Lynn.
All right, seeing as how I'm special, I'll call you Lynette too, okay?
Okay.
All right, now where'd you like to go to dinner tonight? Somewhere posh, I'd reckon. And afterwards we might groove to the disco beat. How's that sound?
You're crazy.
And whatever you want me to be.
How long are you gonna be working here for?
Oh, fixing drains takes forever. I'll see to that. You and I gotta get to know each other, Lynette.
Oh, I can't read Bee's handwriting. What's that say? Don't let the milk... What?
Don't let the milk boil. Uh-oh, too late.
Oh, no. Oh, I should have told you, I'm not a very good cook.
Ah, never mind. Just sit down here, relax. Tuna Mornay happens to be my best dish ever. It'll be ready in two shakes of a leg.
Eddie?
Hmm?
I'm going to look for a job.
Why?
Well, I can't expect you to keep me.
Well, I know I don't earn that much, but it's enough.
I just want to help out.
Well, you will. There's the housework and everything.
No, it's not just that. I'm used to being with people.
Well, what sort of a job do you want?
I don't know. I'll find something. Do you mind?
I guess not. I only want you to be happy, Marilyn.
I am. It's just that I don't like being by myself.
What do you mean? You got me.
Must get pretty lonely for you at the prison. What made you want to work there?
Wasn't exactly my choice. I'm in a clinic. We're the lucky ones who've got responsibility for the prison. I'm junior doctor, so I get the job. Doesn't leave much time for my private practice.
Nor your private life.
No.
Karen didn't make any complaint. How did you meet her?
At uni. My family had just come out from England. I had a pretty hard time adjusting. I think if it hadn't been for Karen, I might have got the next boat back. That's what makes it so hard, seeing the way she's ended up.
Well, it's pretty difficult for some of the women to settle down. I often wonder how I'd be. Listen to me. I'm a fine one to talk. For a while back, I thought I was getting a bit like Vera.
She's a hard one to work out.
Oh, she doesn't have much of a life outside work.
Well, do any of us?
Well, I've got Marty. We usually end up arguing, but at least he brings me back to reality.
Vera's got her mother. That's another relationship I can't quite work out either.
Well, we all have our problems, it seems.
Well, here's to, problems.
I hope Dr. Miller doesn't charge us his full fee.
Why shouldn't he?
You work together. Not that that makes much difference, I suppose. You can't trust doctors. They're all the same. They're out for every penny they can get.
But I thought you liked him.
Did you? Well, don't think that I don't know what's been going on behind my back. Trying to get a nurse in here. Next thing is he'll be trying to put me in a home.
Oh, nonsense. Don't forget to take your pill.
Don't think I don't know what you've been trying to cook up behind my back. I'm not blind. You want to get rid of me, don't you? Your own mother, after all I've done for you, and you turn around and treat me like that. Well, I'm not going. You can tell your doctor friend that. I'm staying here. No one can force me out of my own house. I'm...
Mum! Mum!
was to be expected, Vera. You knew that.
You're starting to look like a shriveled up old prune. No man had ever looked twice at you. Just look at where you work. Prison. Why can't you get yourself a decent job? You're getting old and hard before your time, Vera.
You're silly.
I've got a feeling something big is going to happen today.
Your tea leaves never lie, Bee.
Yeah. There's a prize in the air for someone. Pity I can't see who it is. Someone being mean to you.
You filthy pig! Rotten Doyle!
What's going on here? Lizzie, where am I? Who am I? All right, Franky, what happened? I warn you, I will not tolerate any more of these outbursts, no matter what the reason. Understand? Get out, Lizzie.
Who am I? I can't remember anything.
Can you remember what solitary looks like?
Many qualifications, Miss Mason. I'm afraid most employers are looking for girls with experience these days.
Well, I've been modeling since I left school.
The only kind of position we could offer you would be a cleaning job or perhaps waiting tables.
Anything. I don't mind.
I see you haven't been employed for the past 6 months. Was there any reason for that?
I've been in prison.
I'm sorry, Miss Mason. I'm afraid we don't have anything for you at the moment. Perhaps you could try some of the other agencies.
I've already been to three.
Well, there must be others.
Thank you for your help.
If it is old Mandy, why didn't you tell me you're out?
Hello, Freddie. What do you want?
Why haven't you looked me up?
I've been busy.
You're looking as good as ever, Marilyn.
I'm not coming back, Freddie.
Your customers have been asking after you.
I'm off the game.
You can ask whatever you want, you know.
I'm going straight.
Sure you are.
Look, Freddie, my man will be back soon, and I don't want you hanging around, so get out.
Look, if you change your mind, that's where you'll find me. See you around, Mandy.
Different than on the inside, the sun still shines.